Hi everybody and welcome back to Wander Freely.
Hello.
It's so good to see you again. I feel like it's been a little bit while since we've actually filmed. So yeah, welcome back. Let's just do this. I think we're in our home, as you can see behind us. We're actually in our home, which is very exciting.
We have a little bit more room.
Yeah, a little bit. And we still have some projects to do. We haven't totally finished. So I know that I owe you all a tour, and that is coming at some point, but we still are working on some of our projects. So I feel like I should just wait till it's done instead of trying to do a tour and then doing another tour. I don't know, whatever. So we'll see how that goes. But we're not quite finished yet. In the meantime, though, we are enjoying our new home very much. Chris has a nice new office.
I do. Lots of space. A little bit more than just a desk, so I'm still settling in and loving it.
Yeah, and like, well, the first thing he did was buy another monitor.
More desk space? Nothing wrong with a three monitor setup, right?
What really happened was March Madness. He's not fooling anybody.
The two monitor setup used to be ideal, and then March Madness came along, so I've got to have, you know, I had like the window shrunk down this big so I could still, I got to use the two screens for how I do my work, so the little TV part of it was like this big.
Yeah.
Not anymore.
Okay, so anyway, today we thought that we would do a video talking about some of the questions, answering some of the questions that we see a lot. The question is, do we get lonely RVing? And I think that's a really valid question because, especially if you're planning to RV alone, I think a lot of times, you know, you have the opposite side of that question, which is, do you drive each other crazy? Because it's such a small living space for two people, but
that's probably the more common question, but the lonely one, it's good too.
It is. I think it really shows, because the truth is, we definitely experienced one time where we did feel a little bit lonely.
Yeah, once in 3 years. I think we got a little lonely.
But also, we have seen others and interacted with others, and we've definitely met some people that were lonely.
Yes.
On the road.
Yeah.
For varied reasons, but what I think about is, for the most part, no, we're not lonely at all. We're moving so fast, and
I think a lot of it has to do on what kind of schedule you're keeping. If you're seeing a lot of things and you're moving, you're not really even thinking about, am I lonely?
Yeah, you don't really have time for that. And it is a little bit difficult because you don't have those established relationships on the road. So it's not, especially if you're really connected at home, and we were connected before we left. I mean, and I think that's part of this question too, is people, if you're really, really establishing a community, then you're thinking, what is it really going to be like to leave that and not have that consistently while you travel? You know, so, but for the most part, you don't even think about it because you're just, I don't know, there's so many wonderful things.
I think you're just preoccupied, doing the things that you're doing on the road.
Right, and there are so many wonderful things to see, and if that's your motivation, you will have no problem at all.
Just to talk a little bit about the one time that we were kind of lonely in 3 years, it was when we were staying in one place for a long time. It was the first winter that we were in the RV. We were down in Florida, and we were really enjoying it down there, but what was it? A little over a month in, probably.
Yeah.
You know, we really started to miss family, and it was the holidays too at that time. So that's when we were thinking about the question, were we ever lonely? Initially it was, oh no. And then we got to thinking about it, and it was like, well, wait a minute. Yeah, you know, we were down in Florida, and we drove home.
Yeah.
You know,
18 hours?
Yeah, that's big.
I mean, it was enough to make us drive 18 hours. Like,
right.
It wasn't like 18.
About that. 16 in one day,
Yeah, we were staying in Destin, and we were there for, I think, 2.5 months.
Yes.
And up to then, we had not been anywhere for, like, more than a week.
That's right.
So all of a sudden, we had this long spread, and we thought, oh, this is going to be like paradise. You know, we're going to be in Florida for the winter. Like, usually only retired people get to do that, you know, like, what in the world? We get to do it. This is great. This is, like, fantastic.
It was a dream.
We were swimming outside in December.
Yeah.
I mean, it was crazy.
It was great. It was.
Yeah, it was great. But, you know, then Thanksgiving came around, and we happened to be at a campground that did not have a lot of activities and things. And that's something to keep in mind if you are planning a longer stay, to really evaluate the campground you want to stay at. This was like last minute for us, of course, because that's the way we
kind of how we do it.
That's how we roll. So we ended up in a place that it didn't really have a lot. And even where it was located, it was on an island kind of, and a stretch of it that wasn't really a town. And it was just outside of Destin, which is a great place, but I really felt like it was a little odd being there in the winter, because it felt like you went to a beach place that was...
It kind of felt like a ghost town. I mean,
right.
Because they had so much stuff, because during the busy season, Destin is packed, so there's so much stuff there to do, but it totally empties out in the winter, which makes, it's great there's no traffic, but I mean, it was like a ghost town. I mean, well, I think in 2.5 months we went out to eat twice, and I think like both times, and we were the only people in the restaurant.
Yeah.
And these were like popular seafood places right on the water. We're the only ones in the restaurant. It had emptied out.
Yeah, and it was kind of nice, and I'm absolutely sure that locals and people who live there are so grateful for that break, you know, and that sigh of relief of, you know, from the traffic and the, you know, and it's just like everywhere else. For winter, things kind of slow down. You know, that's not unique to beach towns. That's just everywhere. Just even in the warm places,
Winter stinks.
Yeah. Yes. No.
Just not as much.
Yeah. But then it kind of was like, you know, Thanksgiving rolled around. And we had Thanksgiving just the two of us, and that was fine. Like we have no problem with that whatsoever. But then as it started to draw on farther and farther, then we were like, okay, Christmas is looming, and yeah.
You just get to thinking about family.
Let's go home.
Yep. Yeah. So we did.
So we rented a car and we drove home.
Right.
So yeah.
We surprised everybody. Yeah.
Yeah. And if you haven't seen that video, I'm going to link it up here. I think it's always on my left when I'm sitting here. I'm not sure. Whichever way. But that way. Okay. The snowbird thing, it works really well for some people. And some people, it can add to that loneliness, I think. Because it's over the holidays. It's, you know, leaving everything that your established community and family and going someplace else for a few months. And it can be a little tricky to get that to work out well.
Yeah, it's true. I mean, if you're not in a place with a lot of activities to get involved with, it can turn into a lonely few months pretty quickly.
Right.
Yeah.
Yeah. And then after Destin, we ended up going to Gulf Shores and had pretty much the opposite experience there. And part of that, and this shows you as well that some of that does just depend on the campground that you're in. This place had a ton of activities. It was a town community where the campground itself is located on the outskirts, but it had a town, whereas where we were in Destin was outside of Destin, and it wasn't really a town. So it was just a different, very different feel. You know, but Gulf Shores really, loved it there, and we were there for the whole month of February, no problems, had Mardi Gras for the first time,
oh,
all that
right.
kind of stuff, yeah. And then we were also looking forward to, in March, we were going to hit the road again, do like the southern part of the country out to the West Coast, and then all the way up the West Coast, and so, you know, that it turned a corner at that point. So, but don't get discouraged too, if you feel like
And that works for a lot of people. I mean, some people love the solitude, love the quiet, and they have no issue. You know, they seek it out.
What's interesting to me is we usually tend to that.
Tend towards that, yeah. I mean, I'm not looking for something to do every single day, you know, with the whole campground, you know.
Right.
But it's nice to know that amount of stuff's there if you want to.
Right, yeah. It helped us to be able to establish some relationships while we were there, so, yeah. But out of Destin, and I'm thinking, we did meet Cindy and her family there, and that, she's like one of my favorite friends.
Yeah,
so even though it was a lonely time, I got to meet her. So yeah. Anyway, then outside of that, I think the only other times were, not that we were lonely, but for other people that we saw, particularly, there are some widowers, a lot of single men at that point in their lives. And
yeah, more often you see that, you know, than the, you know, older single women, you know, traveling around like that. So yeah, that's, you know, and that's that can be sad.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, but we just tried to reach out to them and.
Oh yeah.
We've definitely taken them food and done different things and talked with them and spent some time with them, and I would just encourage everybody to do that, because I think that's one of the nice things about a campground.
It's great. I mean, it really is what it's all about. It's so easy if you just a little, you know, just be a little proactive, and the sense of community can, you know, it's great. It really is, talking to all the different folks that you run into.
Oh, gosh. And I just remembered another story when we were in Gulf Shores. Do you remember that guy was, Chris always, you know, you kind of tend to be the youngest people. We're not that young, but we tend to be the youngest people in the campground. And
especially in snowbird season.
Yeah, especially in snowbird. And when we were in Gulf Shores.
I mean, Gulf Shores, I think the next youngest person was like 66.
Yeah.
Everybody was retired.
And there was a gentleman there in his, he was like close to 90, wasn't he? If he wasn't already 90.
Yeah.
I mean, he was doing well. It was really cool.
Still traveling, yeah, still doing the snowbird thing.
It was really cool. But there was a guy next door to us. Since Chris is the younger guy, he tries to keep an eye on if somebody's getting up on their roof, right?
Yeah, from time to time. You know, it's going to happen. You see somebody getting up there, and I'll always try and offer, you know, can I help? I'd be happy to get up there and, you know, do whatever needs to.
Do you remember what happened?
I do, yeah. So the guy that was parked right next to us, is this the really old guy that you're talking about?
Yeah,
he was very old.
He was pretty old, yeah.
You know, active, and this one particular day, it was February, but it was still warm, you know, so we were out. I was doing something around the camper, and he comes out, and he starts climbing up. To get on top of his roof. And so I asked him, I was like, you know, sir, do you need any help? I'd be happy to do that for you. And he said, I forget the exact wording, but it was something, I'll paraphrase, it was basically, you know, no, son, I've been waiting for weeks to have something to do, and you're not going to take this away from me. And he got up, did what he needed doing, and he had no problems at all. So,
yeah. And so I think the point in his case was not that he was lonely, but, you know, some
of the guys get a little, and I'm sure, you know, the women, we've talked to a number of, you know, the men that I think there's an adjustment period for them. I think they get a little bored. I mean, because you'll see them out every single day walking around the camper looking for something to do, you know, something that's out of place, something they can fix, something they can clean.
Yeah. Especially, I think, if they're used to doing that stuff at home. Like, if they do a lot of stuff with
their
hands.
Newly retired, you know?
Yeah.
It's a big adjustment anyway. Now you're out on the road, and yeah.
Yeah, and you're sitting in one place. And yeah, he was just so funny. He's like, nobody's taking this away from me.
Yeah.
It was a really cute story.
Yeah, I liked him a lot.
Yeah. Okay, so I think we're just going to wrap up this video. I hope that you've been able to pull some
It got a little... But
yeah, a little watch.
There should be some good stuff in there. Watch it again if you need to.
Yeah.
It's in there. Trust us.
Oh, mercy. Okay. Well, yeah, and I hope that does answer some of your questions. It just shows you a little bit and maybe helps to prepare you in such a way that you'll be able to really enjoy RVing. And keep in mind, if you are having a hard time, if you are lonely, or whatever it is, whatever obstacle, you know, just keep in mind, it may change at the next campground. It could change at the next, you know...
Yeah. The next destination that you have on your list.
Yeah. Absolutely. It'll change, so...
And, you know, when you're out there camping, you're never alone. I mean, there's just so many good people out there.
Yes.
Camping right along with you. So,
yeah.
Yeah.
I think,
campgrounds
are special.
True.
Yeah, believe it because it's true. Because it's, we had no idea how special that this community was until we started experiencing it. And everybody out there is just really, really great and helpful and all of those things.
Yeah, it's a lot of good.
Yeah. So if you're looking to take the plunge, go ahead and do it because you're going to love it.
You will. Go for it.
And if you have other questions that are kind of RV living related, feel free to leave them in the comments below and we will be happy. More than happy to answer them for you.
Until next time.
Yeah, thanks so much for watching. Give us a thumbs up and subscribe. And yeah, we'll see you next time.
Thanks, guys.
And one last thing before I go. I just want to say a very, very big thank you to all of you because our channel has actually surpassed 10,000 subscribers. So if you can believe it, it's just kind of incredible. We just never thought... It's more than we ever really imagined. So we just want to say thank you so very much. We are so appreciative and grateful that you join us and that you see value in what we do here on our channel. Our purpose for this channel is kind of three main purposes. One is to share this beautiful, amazing country of ours with others, to give people a really warm welcome into the RVing lifestyle, and also to make sure that it's informative and helps people along their own journey so that they can get in the RV, so they can renovate their RV, whatever they need to do, whatever steps they need to take along the process. So we just want to say a big thank you for joining us and for making this channel really what it is. And we have a lot more coming up. Like I said, we'll be doing some of the house stuff. And then also we're going to be hitting the road soon. If you can even imagine, like, I can't believe we're already at that point again. And it's just, I think being in the house has been such a big blessing for us, and we love the house, and we've been so grateful for it. But at the same time, having a break has given us even more excitement for the upcoming trip. So we are just thrilled to hit the road again, and we're going to be heading all the way out to Utah and back again. We're gonna be hitting some places we've hit before and also some new places as well. So we are super excited for our trip, and we are hoping to share that with you as we go. So thanks so much.